So how do you save an entire website, keep it super accurate as far as where all the images and text are, save it as a PDF or an image, and use a Mac? Let's find out. All right, so why is this video important again, and why would people even want to do this? The reason people might want to save a website like this is maybe they just want to document something or archive something exactly the way it was, not moved around, not reformatted, exactly the way it was on a website. Maybe they want to go on a plane ride or something and they don't have internet access and they want to save this as a PDF or some kind of an image document so they can pull up and just read it or save it for later or whatever. That's the reason you'd want to do it. There's three methods of doing this, and a lot of people are going to say right away, I don't need to watch this because I know how to do this already. And that first method is definitely I'm going to show you here. It's doable. You can easily do it. It's free and it's you know, works a lot of the time. But the problem is it doesn't always format the text correctly because it's going to format it more for a printing document versus just a viewing document. So I'm going to show you the first technique, and that's not what I'm talking about, but that'll be one way you can do it. It just is not going to be a one-for-one representation of that website, so it's not exactly what I'm talking about. The second option is to go ahead and buy software, which you can do. Again, you want to spend the money? Probably most people don't, so that's probably not an option. I'll show you a good choice if you want to go ahead and buy something, but at the end of the day, again, that's not the best option. The number three option, which I'm going to show you here, and I'm going to go ahead and just watch the video here, and I'll show you exactly how to do it. It's free. You do need some software for it, which is free software, and it's surprisingly easy, and it'll be a one-for-one representation saved in either a PDF or a graphic. And what I mean by that is you can go like to ESPN, let's say it's got a web page that you have to scroll down for 20 minutes. It's gonna grab everything, keep exactly the formatting, all the pictures, everything perfect for you, not moving things around. And then you can have that for later, or you can have archive it if you need to. So let's get into the video. I'm gonna keep it short. I just wanna show people how this is done and how easy this is, and it's free. Let's get going. All right, so the first format that I'm not recommending is if you go into something, I use Chrome a lot, and you can use Safari, whatever you wanna use. It doesn't really matter. You can use the same technique, and this is probably what you're used to. So I just went to Mac Rumors. You can see how everything's formatted here. So if I wanted to save this as a PDF or a graphic, a lot of people know that they can go up to File. They can go to Print now and print, you know, like you're gonna print it. And if you, you know, what happens is the printing actually will preview it. You can see it loading here. But if I scroll down, you can see how, like, it's not exactly, I mean, they make it look better because they want it to print better. So they take away a lot of, like, the blue space behind it, and they just put text here. So at the end of the day, it doesn't look anything like the website does. So I can go over here now and say destination, and I can say save as PDF, or I can go to my printer. So if I change this to save to PDF right here, and then I go ahead and I save this, I'll show you. So let's go ahead and save it, and it's going to go to my desktop, which I'm going to go to. So look there. So here it is. But let's go ahead and take a look at this now. Now, if I actually preview this, look at it. So here it is, but it looks nothing like the website. It's definitely saved all the text and everything, but look at it. It's got all this white space and everything. So this is not working. If I go back to the actual website itself, that's what the website looked like, and it doesn't look like that. So that technique doesn't work. So that's number one. That's the one everyone really knows about, but I don't recommend using. All right, so the second way you can do this is, and I don't recommend this either, is you can get something like Snagit, you know, for Mac or whatever, something like this, and it costs like $50, and you can go ahead then and have some power and download entire websites exactly the way they look. All graphics will be where they should be and stuff. But a lot of this software costs, I mean, at least $25 up to $50, sometimes more. So again, do you want to do that? No, plus you got to have more software on there. I don't say do it, so like I say, let's just go with the free version. I'll show you how to do this the best way for free. Let me show you. All right, so how do we do this for free? This is how you do it. Now, everyone obviously has Safari on a Mac, and I use Chrome, but there's one reason to download Firefox. You can go to, you know, look for Firefox for a Mac, just download it as a free download. It takes literally 30 seconds. Go ahead and pull that up. Now, I'm gonna have Mac Rumors just like I did everywhere else. Take a look at it, and I have it in Firefox. The easiest thing to do here is, here's my cursor. Up here, if you can see my cursor up right up here, I got the three little dots up here. You click on these three little dots right here, and I'm gonna click on that. And then down here it says take a screenshot. See that right there? So when I click that, it's gonna, you know, basically create this little icon here up in the upper right-hand corner. It's gonna say save full page, save visible. So what you wanna do is you wanna do save full page right there. Click on it. And what it's gonna do is it's gonna do its little thing, but you could see right away that it's created a, you know, basically it's created this JPEG of the website, but it's exactly the way it was when you actually were on the website. It's not all moved around. So if you go up here to download, you can see it right here, click download. And it's going to do its little thing here, and it's going to go ahead and download that. And basically what it does is it saves it now as a JPEG. So I can go ahead and just close minimize Firefox. I actually had it saved from before just to show you, but down here, I'm just going to open it up. You can see what it did. So here it is. I took a screenshot of it. It's Mac Rumors. It's the website, but look at it. It looks completely different. So if I zoom in on this, it's not going to just be the text like it was before, but it's going to be very, very close, the representation of what it was. So you can actually take a look at it, and it's going to save it almost exactly like it was. So that's just a tip if you want to go ahead and do this. Again, it's not mind-changing. You know, it's not going to be something that's going to change your life or whatever, but at the end of the day, it is a tip that helps. I think some people, if they want to go ahead and capture a screen exactly the way it looks. All right, so I hope that helps people. Again, there's a lot of different ways you can do this, and you can argue a couple different things as far as, you know, do you really need it to be exactly the same? But some people, for some reason, want to, you know, archive stuff, or they want to show graphics in a certain light. So you don't want things moved around when you save it. You want them to be exactly the way you saw that website. And that's the best method I just showed you for doing it right now if you don't want to spend any money. Obviously, if you spend money, there's better options out there. They're probably easier to use, and they probably have a lot more power to them. But if you want to do something free, just do what I said. You know, download Firefox, go ahead and do exactly the steps I said, and there you go. You have a saved version of that web page. You can store it for later. Go ahead and read it while you're maybe on a plane or something where there's no internet. So that's the reasons why you'd want to do that. So I hope this helps everyone out there. I'm just trying to show some tips. Definitely support my channel if you can. I make a couple videos a week, as you know, and anything I can get as far as support and subscribers, it's going to help me out grow the channel. So we'll talk to you soon. Peace.